yeah, because we just have a billion people in China. That means 1 billion, just a percent, 1 minute. Okay, good afternoon. I would like to thank UNU-WIDER again for inviting me to this conference. So Finn told me that I just give a brief introduction to the latest change in the income inequality in China in 10 minutes, that is. Ravi Campbell just talked about changing income inequality in China yesterday. He mentioned that in the last decade, income inequality has been declining. Yeah, I think, he's right. So if you just look at official data set, that is the figure of the Gini coefficient of income inequality in the last 12 years. That is estimated by National Bureau of Statistics that based on the household survey conducted by National Bureau of Statistics. So the trend is very clear. That means income inequality increased, you see, before 2008. Then after 2008, income inequality has been declined, constantly. You see, in the 2008, Gini coefficient is close to 0.5. Nowadays, it's less than 0.47, that is. So, of course, there are a lot of people have a debate on that, whether this figure is accurate or not. That we know the Chinese survey is conducted by, you see, National Bureau of Statistics or by some universities. They have the common problem. Yeah, Francis just mentioned that. Just have missing data on the top their income groups, also have some ending reporting problem, that is. The same problem, with this official data, that is. If we look at the data from our surveys, Jimmy Davis just mentioned our surveys, that we call the CHIPS survey, the China Household Income Project data. We collect this data from 1988, that is the first year we conduct data. Then we have the conduct data in 95, 2002, and 2007. The latest is from 2013. Then we calculate the Gini coefficient just between in the year of 2007 and 2013. If you look at Gini, it's become smaller. In the 2013 compared to 2007. Also, if we look at the income ratio of the top decile to the top, the bottom decile, also the ratio is declined. So, so the data from our surveys is a little different from the official data. We use the different definition of the household income. In the official, the data is the imputed way, the rent of the private housing is not included, but we did, we include that. So that means from our data, we will get a little bit high income inequality than official data. Also, if you look at, you see, income growth curve for the different decile, also you can see that from 2007 and 2013, you see low income growth, have high income growth, then high income growth. Okay. Of course, all that also have that's a common problem. We have under representative of the top income group. Also, we also have the problem of under reporting. But why income inequality decline? Then we just look at, you see, whether it's happened in the rural area or in the urban area, or the just between rural and urban areas. So we did some preliminary analysis just try to look at, you see, Gini coefficient within urban area and within rural area. Then we found that, you see, Gini coefficient either in rural area or the urban area is Gini continuous rising, you see. That means, yeah, income, total income equality in the country as a whole, the largely come from decline of income gap between rural and urban area. So that means, yeah, if we just look at, that income ratios between urban household and the rural household, the figure is very clear. You will see that. That ratio, you see, rose till the 2009, something like that. After that, the ratio declined till now. That is. So the figure from last year is about, you see, less than three times. It's a significant decline in the income gap between rural and urban areas. So also, if you just do some decomposition analysis, you will find, you see, decomposite total inequality in the country as a whole into between rural and urban area, and within rural and urban area, we'll find a big, the drop between inequality and the slightly increase, within inequality. That means the decline between the rural and the urban area is much larger than the rising within rural and urban area. So why we have seen is the decline between income inequality between urban and rural areas? There are a lot of explanations, something like that. I just, emphasize perhaps some important equalizing facts, something like that. That some is a hypothesis indeed. So the first is that if you just look at the growth rate of GDP in China, the over times, you will say that from 2007, its growth rate becomes slowed down, indeed, compared to the previous year. So that means slow down in the economic growth may have contributed to decline the income inequality in China. That's why, just because faster economic growth benefited more to urban people, to some large enterprise, to some state-owned enterprise, to some new, you see, industries, some IT and the financial sector, that is. Perhaps slow down economic growth without negative impact on the unemployment, perhaps that will benefit some even lower income growth, indeed. Second important element is that, you see, you know that, also Ravi Campbell mentioned that, that is transitions, you see, from agriculture to the industries, you see, migration from rural area to urban area, that really make a big impact on the reducing the income inequality. That is the number of the rural migrants to the urban areas. You see, in last, the decade, you will see that number increased. That means there are no surplus labor in the rural areas. You see, also if you look at the increase of the wages of rural migrants, it has a big increase, you see, in the last 5 years, indeed. That means that will increase the income of rural households because they send remittance to home. Also, you see, a lot of reduced the labors in the agriculture. That means increased labor productivity in agriculture sectors, indeed. Also, we should realize that there are a lot of the public policy have been introduced in the last decade to supporting the rural household, indeed. You see, I just list, this is the policy that is, like in 2006, the government abolished agriculture tax. Also, you see, exempt school fee for students in the rural areas. Also, some DBO program, like you see, minimum income supporting program, also implemented in rural and urban area. Also, government gave some agriculture subsidy to rural household, and the hukou reform and the rural migration increase. Also, some new social security program, like new rural medical care scheme, new rural pension scheme. That means people living in a rural area, age over 60, they can receive subsidies from the government. Yeah. Also, the government increased enormously financial support for some anti-poverty programs, indeed. So if you just look at the income components for rural people, you will find transfer income as share of the total income increased significantly between 2007 and 2013, you see, close to 15% of the total income. Also, if you look at its contribution to the total inequalities, even have a big increase, you see, the impact on the total inequality remain unchanged because, you see, that is transfer income more equalized, distributed among the rural households. So that really have the big impact on the poverty, indeed. That is low income, poor household receive more transfer income from the government. Yeah, this figure indicated, you see, the trend of the poverty reduction in China in rural area. You will see whatever the poverty line we used, you will have a very clear trend. Poverty reduction is very clear. Either you use low poverty line or medium poverty line or even the high poverty line. As you mentioned that, you see, from 2010, the government adopted the poverty line is equal to $2, you see, per person per day, something like that. Even you say look at the poverty rate by using the new poverty line, you see also the big decrease in the poverty incidence indeed. Okay, thank you.